Holy Spirit, we will never be the same.
Ephesians 5:20, giving thanks always for, are you here? See, now she bust you out. She said, Apostle, I see what you're talking about. She told you that 18 months of rent was written off. And here you go. It's Apostle, look at it. I need to hire her as an assistant preacher.
Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
When y'all are not acting right, I hand her the mic.
Praise God.
Giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father. Name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, do you notice the semicolon there? That tells you that the thought is not finished. Submitting yourselves unto another in the fear of God. This is why, for a few minutes, I'm calling this message the Thanksgiving you never knew. I've shown you through the years the thanksgiving is preferred by God to anything else you can give to him. A heartfelt thank you will produce miracles.
Amen.
And the exhortation he gave me at the beginning of this service is the crux of the matter where people can get their breakthrough, because there's always a frustration. There's always a tension at the cusp of your breakthrough. And that's when you win or lose it. And when you get there, and then anger rises up, or you get an attitude, or you start murmuring, you ruin everything.
Amen.
That's the time for you to show God, I belong to you.
Amen.
I've transferred ownership. I'm not my own man anymore.
Amen.
Jesus preached one sermon in John 5, and 5,000 people left. And he looked at his disciples and said, would you leave also? And Peter said, where shall we go? That is what is missing in people's lives. Where shall I go? In other words, Lord, without you, where am I going? Who else is out there? Who else do I believe in? Who else can save me? Who else can help me? Who else? This is not a religion. You have to prove to heaven and hell what kingdom you're in, who your Lord is. That's what I tell Satan all the time. You can attack me all you want to, but I'm telling you now, I'm not coming your way. Jesus Christ is my Lord. Not faking it, it's reality. I serve God hungry. I serve God in pain. I've served God when other people were rejoicing. And I didn't see anything, but I praised him anyway. Hallelujah. I never knew that the reason believers have all these raunchy attitudes is the lack of thanksgiving.
Amen.
The text says, if you give thanks to God for all things, not some things. He says, immediately you will be able to submit one to another. Because giving him thanks changes something in your heart. Breaks the satanic hold in your life. Delivers you from pride. And the devil holding you and your generation, his yoke is snapped. I was teaching my leaders these things. And one Saturday morning, we were at the altar. And God gave me a vision. And I saw my leaders come to the door of something and then just turned around. I started going round and around. And I said to them, if you don't pass this test, you will not get anywhere in this kingdom. And I'm telling you this morning, if you don't pass this test, you won't get anywhere. No matter who lays hands on you or anoints you with oil, your deliverance will come from within you. That's what Jesus says. He says, he said to those who believe in him, he says, if you continue in my word, then you are truly my disciple. He's telling you there are so many fake disciples. They talk it, but they don't do it. He said, if you continue. Why would he say if you continue? He didn't say if you do. If you continue, meaning that things will come along to want to cause you to quit it, amen, to get back in pride, amen, to stop murmuring and complaining. Amen. But I'm telling you this, thanks, give it money. Hey, that's why I said I came to chase generational devils out that door, out that door, out that door. I'm giving you weapons to break the chains off your neck, off your life, off your destiny. Hey! He said, if you give thanks for all things, he said, you'll be able to submit one to another. That's the miracle that hasn't happened for most people.
Amen.
You think you've done everything right, but you keep failing it. I was looking at that thing because I've heard someone preach that you cannot give God thanks for everything because you will be giving him credit for what Satan has done. But they didn't read that text. They preached their own understanding. But you see, the reason we preach these things in our generation is that we are running from suffering. But Paul not only suffered, but he had the audacity to say that whatever the Lord Jesus did not suffer for the church, that God chose him to make up those sufferings. Jesus was beaten with the cat of nine tails 39 times once. Paul had it 3 times. Paul was stoned. Jesus wasn't. Paul suffered shipwreck. Jesus didn't. Paul was incarcerated, beaten so many times. Jesus wasn't. That's who I listened to. He said, give him thanks. Hallelujah. Hey! He couldn't have penned it if he didn't live it.
Amen. Amen.
When the enemy is dancing on your shoulders and mocking you for believing God.
Come on now.
For putting your seed in the ground. Yeah. That's when you get up and say, thank you, Lord. I know my destiny is certain. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to a prepared place. Thank you, Lord. You've been praying for patience and, oh Lord, remove this temper from me. You know, he showed you how the miracle happens. He said, you won't be able to submit until you can thank God Amen. For what you're mad about.
Amen. Thank you, God.
That's why he put that colon, semicolon there. He's telling you the thought is not finished. Giving thanks to God. Always. You notice always. Not sometimes. Always. For all things. Submitting yourselves. One to another. In the fear of God. That's why I told you that this altar is at your house. Wherever there's a covenant, God is there.
Amen. Amen.
If you knew that, you wouldn't be cussing each other out. You wouldn't be using foul language. You wouldn't be watching any other stuff. You know. You want your altar to prove true, to have power. I told you the other night when we were celebrating a church birthday, I said, it never ceases to amaze me that I could be with somebody in the room, in my office, and just say words. And the God of all creation that was here before I was born, that will be here long after I'm gone, responds. I don't know how far he is from, you know, in a physical distance, and he will respond. His presence will show up.
Amen.
I find those things amazing.
Hallelujah. Amen.
You know, the problem with believers is that, you know, you give testimony to they have never experienced these things before. And now you're used to it. So much so that some of you are running from me because you don't want to fall down. Do you know how expensive that falling down is? Do you know how many people have preached a whole year and trying to break people's neck, trying to get them to fall down? And that I will wave at you, right? Hold up my hand and the glory comes on you. You should be saying, hey, Lord, let me fall. Touch me every time. It's because you don't know what you're getting.
Amen. Praise God.
You are the forerunners of a global move of the Spirit. God is testing our resurrection glory on you. Hallelujah. There's no time. I've only got into one scripture. Well, next year. Glory to God. He says, in the fear of God, you submit yourselves one to another. In the fear of God. What miracle will change? Or what miracle will be birthed in you? What change will occur in you today? If you get this message, you will no longer act out. Because the reason Satan gives you to act out turns into a praise. Lord, I thank you that you're allowing me to go through this. I thank you. Hallelujah. And suddenly, the spirit of rebellion will leave you. Spirit of anger will leave you. Spirit, the yoke on your neck will be broken. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Glory. 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 Glory.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We declare that you own us. We declare that we are yours. We declare that it is only you we will worship. Watch. Watch what he just said to me. He just said, son, what you're preaching is the test I passed in the wilderness. He said, Satan came to me and offered me that if I worshiped him, I can bypass the cross and he will return the kingdom to me. And I said to him, get thee behind me, Satan. Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God and him only. May that be your testimony. There's no other God for me. There's no other God for our family. There's no other God for this marriage. There's no other God. Hey, who is like unto thee, O Lord? Among the gods, who is like you? Glorious, glorious, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders. Doing wonders. Ooh, hallelujah. Yay. Yay. We have come family by family, but there are some things that, okay, he just said to me to give you the opportunity to do it first, and then I will guide you. He said, now for you to lift your hands and give God thanks for this church. So whatever that's in your heart towards this church that you appreciate now, tell him that. Tell him that whatever this church means to you, has done for you, thank him now. We are sealing a breakthrough for the next year. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank God for Resurrection House. Thank God for the word of resurrection. Thank God for miracles in this house. Thank God for signs and wonders and miracles. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Yay. That's what he wants. Thank him. Mean it. Mean it. Glory in this house. We thank you for miracles in this house. We thank you for signs and wonders in this house. We thank you for the word of resurrection in this house. We thank you for supernatural finance in this house. Hallelujah. Yay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yay. Yay. The glory is here. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. 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 Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Know therefore that the Lord thy God, he is God. The faithful God who keepeth covenant and mercy with them that love him and keep his commandments to 1,000 generations. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the eternal God, who is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Our destiny is secure for the next 12 months. In Jesus' name. Beloved, thanksgiving is such a force of glory, a force of victory, a force of deliverance. You don't know the warfare raging, even in your life. You don't understand the dynamics of it. Satan couldn't stop you from coming to the Lord Jesus and being born again and redeemed. So he couldn't stop that. So he starts a massive war against you through frustrations, through lack, through sickness, and through this and through that. But when you stand your ground and lift up and hallelujah and praise God, you break the yokes of Satan. You make your breakthroughs permanent. Hallelujah. Who is like unto thee, O God? You would end up there. God grows bigger and more precious in your life. Who is like unto thee, O Lord? Who is like thee? Glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders among the gods. Which gods? You know, the little g's. You know, the Bible says that these gods that did not make the heavens and the earth will perish from the earth. I pray it. I decree it. I expect it. That's why Islam will come down. That's why Buddhism will come down. And all these names you will name. We will prove in these last days that Jesus Christ is Lord. It will not be talk. It will be glory demonstrations, power demonstrations. The realms of glory, the angels of God will come down to demonstrate God's power, God's glory, God's fury against Satan and against evil and against these lying devils running around faking as gods. We will put them in their place. in these last days in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Join us as God's new army. It doesn't matter what you've gone through. We have all gone through. It doesn't matter what pain you're enduring. We're all in pain. We're all in travail. It's what happens before birth. We're about to give birth to something supernatural, something miraculous, something no devil can contain. That is the charge from the throne. That is what's happening now in this Thanksgiving season. Thanksgiving, as I said earlier, makes your breakthrough permanent. But above all, it opens the door to wholeness. You get the full package. You don't get healed like the lepers, and the signs of leprosy are still on you. You get your fingers restored, your toes restored, every deformity removed from your body and from your life. Thanksgiving is at the altar. Thanksgiving is to God. Thanksgiving is a way to show a heart towards Him, a gratitude for His miracles, signs, and wonders. God will open your eyes, and as you faithfully submit to what we are sharing with you, your life becomes miraculous. Thank God for Jesus. Thank God for the Word of God showing us the pathway to access the supernatural in the Lord our God. Amen. Bye-bye.